You can't have missed it. Reanimated 2 is literally everywhere. And that's for a reason, since it's so great to use. What you might have realized too, is that many people show what they can do with it, but too little of us know how to use it ourselves. So today, you will learn about how Reanimated 2 works for someone who has never used it, or know a little bit about animated. Alright, let's begin. Before we start, just a heads up. In React Native, there's a way of animating elements using what they call animated. Although this video is about Reanimated, which is a totally different library, I'll still make a few parallels with the animated API. So just try to remember, if I say animated, I mean the built-in animation library, not Reanimated. Just wanted to clear things out. When you want to animate a view opacity in React Native, you might think of state. It starts with a default value that is later updated. The problem with this is that the animation logic lies on the JavaScript side of things. If our application is busy fetching data, loading a screen, or if we're using a low-end device, the animation might be very slow. The way this can be solved is by sending all the work to a separate box called the UI thread, which can do all the work smoothly since it works separately from the main thread of the app. In Reanimated, they have this concept of worklet, which just means that some code written in JavaScript should run on the UI thread instead. This is a usual function running on the JavaScript thread, and this is the same function running on the UI thread when called. So I know this is weird, but just remember that whenever a function starts with this worklet string, it means that the following code will run in a separate box and therefore won't be impacted by large computations on the JavaScript thread. Back to our state problem, Reanimated actually have a way for your state to live on that UI thread. You can think of it as a useState worklet, which does the same thing but inside that other box. So it isn't called state, but a shared value. They called it shared because you create it from the JavaScript thread, but it is then sent to the other one. So the value gets shared between two threads, our two boxes. The use shared value reanimated hook lets you create an animated value in a single line without any mention of a worklet. But remember, that's how it actually works behind the scenes. If you're coming from animated, this works a lot like an animated value, except that it can carry any type of data, numbers, booleans, objects, anything. We'll keep the opacity at zero for now, but you get the idea. All right, now there are two things you still need to learn about shared values. One is to get its current value, you can't just call opacity like a state, but by using opacity.value. We'll get back to this later. And if you want to update that value, you might be tempted to call setValue just like in animated. But in reanimated, you can change its value as you would with any other variable. Perfect. I mean, we're much closer now from a great animation. Truth is, at this point, our view won't know how to deal with a shared value in its style because it isn't just a number. Just like in animated, where we need to turn the element into an animated one, that's our first step for React Native to deal with this. Let's replace that view with an animated.view that we get from reanimated. By the way, Reanimated has a few basic elements like animated.image, .scrollView, etc., which comes really handy. Okay, so that's where it gets tricky once again. These elements with React Native Animated could understand animated values, but in Reanimated, you can't just pass a plain object to an element. Because it is a shared value that lives in a different box, and also because it will change over time and be manipulated, it is better if all the computation happens also in that other box. The second thread can take care of generating the styling based on changes, dependencies, and all of this won't happen on the JavaScript thread, which is a great boost for your animations. Just like you would call StyleSheet.create, Reanimated has its own way of styling things with the useAnimatedStyle hook that takes a function that returns a style object. It feels different, doesn't it? The way you can easily remember this is that every style that won't animate can be created with a React Native style sheet. However, if a style property changes based on a shared value, that's the case with opacity here, then it needs to go through that hook. You might also have heard about interpolation, and if not, I'll explain it briefly. Here we animate opacity from 0 to 1, and we might also want to animate another style property based on the opacity value. If I want to increase the view size when the opacity increases, I can do this by interpolating the opacity shared value. I will need to map the opacity to what the scale should equal to based on the current opacity value. So here, the scale will be 0.5 when the opacity is 0 and 1 when it is 1. This is similar to value.interpolate with animated, by the way. With this code, we animate the opacity, but also scale the view up when that opacity goes to 1. And you know what? After all this work, we're still not animating the way we should. But using a shared value and an animated style, you just prepared the whole ground for animating smoothly that opacity and any other property at full speed on literally any device. By the way, quick note, you might be wondering, what if you want to animate other properties, not just style? Some of you might know about the set native props in React Native, which is not really recommended, but with Reanimated, you can do it in a better way with use animated props. This works just like an animated style, but it returns props that are computed on the UI thread. You might need this for animating SVG paths like this one, for example, but it will work for anything else. There's really a reason why everyone loves Reanimated, and we're getting there, so bear with me. If we go back to our use effect, I'll be honest with you, this is bad, slow, and so not Reanimated style. Here, we're setting a 25 milliseconds interval to update our shared value. The problem once again is that this will run on the JavaScript thread. With animated, you probably remember animated.timing or spring that handled that for you. The idea is to ask the UI thread to update your animated value to a different one in an optimized way. Well, in Reanimated, you can do the same thing with shared values and it is much simpler. This will update our opacity from 0 to 1 over 1 full second, all running on the UI thread. If you want a spring animation, just use with spring. And this will automatically run a spring animation for you on the opacity shared value. Of course, this is just a simple animation, but there's a lot more that can be done in a few lines, just like delaying the animation for 2 seconds, let's say. You can also repeat it a number of times back and forth, and it will actually know how to swing back to the original value again and again. You can even loop the animation forever. And if you want a sequence of animations, that's possible too. The documentation is really great if you want to get all the details, but here you have it, fast animations on any device in one line. Okay, so by now, you know as much as I do that in our daily apps, there are animations, but also tons of gestures. If most of them are usually handled by your navigation library, you might need to zoom on an image, reorder elements, or play with a bottom sheet. You can do this as well with Reanimated, and again, it will run on the UI thread, so you're not losing in performance. Let's say we want to move this circle around on both the X and Y axis. You can achieve this with Reanimated combined with React Native Gesture Handler, which is a faster, more advanced version of a pan responder. I will create 2 shared values to store our current touch position, 1 for each axis. This is necessary so that when we touch the screen, we can reflect that touch movement on our view so that it moves along our touch. Now, just like a pan responder, I will create a gesture handler which describes the logic of a gesture and how our app should respond to these touch events. This handler will store the touch position when the gesture is active and then spring animate the value to its initial position when it ends. That's all there is for the logic. Now, two more things. First, we need to move our view according to our touch value. And because touch X and Y are shared values, if we want to style a view based on their changes, remember that we can only do this through an animated style. So let's add it to our current one. And for our view to react to our touch, we need to wrap it with a pan gesture handler, just so it knows which element events to listen to. Let's import it from React Native Gesture Handler. Pretty cool, isn't it? And the code is just so simple. It's even too simple if you've ever struggled with pan responder and animated before. If you're curious, you can play with other gesture handlers that the library comes with. It's really neat and simple to integrate with Reanimated. All right, last stop, and I promise we're done after this one, is about scroll handlers. It is very common to animate something based on the scroll position. In our case, we could wrap our circle with a scroll view, and whenever we scroll beyond the boundaries, the background color should turn gray. To do so, we need to store the vertical scroll position somewhere, so we then can animate the background color accordingly. Let's create a shared value for this and a scroll handler that will update the value whenever we move the scroll view. Of course, we need to attach this handler to the scroll view itself that will turn into an animated one as well. Perfect, we have the scroll position now and can interpolate it to the scroll view background color. For this, we'll need to turn a number into a color. Since the interpolate function can only return numbers, this will not work. That's actually a little different with animated, but anyways, let's use interpolate color this time. It interpolates a shared value and turns it into a color. So what this says is when the vertical scroll is at 0, meaning at the initial position, the color should be white. But whenever we start scrolling up or down within 50 pixels, we should interpolate scroll Y into shades of gray. Okay, that one was intended. Anyways, we just animated this background color based on the scroll position, and again, it's all running on the UI thread without any extra effort. We've learned quite a few things today, so let's sum this up. Use shared value stores any data that is meant to change over the component lifecycle. This works pretty much like state, but on the UI thread. Use animated style works like a style sheet, except that it is meant to return an animated style. Every component style property that should be animated or that depends on a shared value should end up there. Interpolate takes a shared value, a range of possible values called the input range, and map them to other outputs. It basically computes a new value based on the current progress of a shared value. When you want to interpolate a shared value into colors, use interpolate color instead. Now, looking at animations with timing, with spring, with decay, are three simple ways of animating shared values from one value to another. They can be delayed, repeated, or put in a sequence. Lastly, gestures, either using the handlers from React Native Gesture Handler, pan, pinch, long press, etc., or a simple scroll handler. All right, this was a quick tour of Reanimated. It is by far the easiest way of creating complex animations, and if you don't know where to begin with, you can expect a lot more of it on this channel. Remember to subscribe if you don't want to miss it. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.